GFamily.
Welcome back to a new car talk video. Today we're going to talk about
my fibromyalgia story.
All right, go ahead.
All right, so we'll talk about how it started first. 3 to 4 years ago, I think it was, I started getting random hives all the time, like everywhere. And we thought at first that it was my anxiety because it seemed to be happening when I was super anxious.
Right.
So we just put it off as my anxiety, and I finally got treated for anxiety last year. And then within the last like year and a half, probably the last year, it's gotten a lot worse. All of a sudden, with the hives came really bad joint pain. And my hands would get so bad that they'd be like rashy and red, and I couldn't grab grab anything cold from the freezer. Otherwise, it just swells my hands up and just puts the most burning pain in my hands ever. And then once that happens, my whole body will just start into a full entire body pain. So then we really couldn't figure out what was going on. And then it got to the point where it was no longer just my hands starting to flare. I was having days where I'd be like laying down, I'd wake up and I couldn't move off the bed.
Really?
Or I'd be like, our sister would be in town and we'd have an active full day. And then all of a sudden I sit on the couch at 1 o'clock in the afternoon and I can't get myself off the couch. So then my wife is having to grab my hand and pull me off of the couch because my body's in so much pain, I cannot move myself. There's been times where that same day I couldn't get off the couch, I'd get a Powerade to try and get some electrolytes to see if that would help, because we didn't know what was going on. My hands were so weak, I couldn't open a Powerade bottle. I couldn't twist it even at all. I could not twist, like, I couldn't grip it. So she had to open it for me, and that's when we got really concerned. So then we went to my GP, my general physician, and told him what was going on. And he was like, okay, he was like, well, with the issues you're having with your three hands, his first thought was rheumatoid arthritis.
Right.
So he was like, I'm going to treat you for anxiety and give you this, really strong antihistamine for allergies. And he was like, I want you to take that and come back in 6 weeks so we can schedule, like, a yearly physical so that insurance would cover it properly. And we'll do a bunch of tests and blood tests then. And I was like, okay, fine. So, the allergy meds didn't do anything. So then I just made sure to document for those 6 weeks what was going on. And over those 6 weeks, it got a lot worse. Like,
really?
So much worse. Yeah, my hand's numb right now.
That's crazy.
A lot worse. So, like, there was more and more days where I could barely move. I was missing probably 2 days a week of work because I could just physically not move. There was mornings that I was in so much pain, it was taking me 10, 15 minutes just to get off the bed and get myself to the bathroom. And it's literally right across the hall from our bathroom because it was so bad. So then I had an appointment with the general physician 6 weeks later, and he was like, okay, he was like, for your age, I'm only 25, I was 24 at the time, so he was like, for your age, you should not be having days where you can't get off a bed, you can't get off a couch, you can't open a Powerade. He was like, you should not be having days like that, like, that's where really, really worrisome. So he was like, I'm gonna put in a referral to a rheumatologist, which studies, like, rheumatoid arthritis and autoimmune illnesses. And she was like, I need you to go get checked with them, because he goes, I'm starting to think it's fibromyalgia or lupus or those things. So I was like, okay. So that was in the end of July. No, God, that was the end of June when I had that. So he got the referral to the rheumatologist. Rheumatologist called me on that Monday to schedule an appointment. The only thing they had open was September 9th, and that was the end of June when they had called me. So I had 3 months that I had to wait in between.
Jeez.
That. So then I was like, okay. So then I started making sure I got this, like, notebook journal, and I was journaling, like, every single symptom I had, every single one. That way, and, like, the time it was happening, how long it lasted, that way when I had my meeting with my rheumatologist, I was able to be like, okay, this is everything that's happening. Here's a record of it. This is the times, everything. And those 3 months, 2-3 months, was even worse than those 6 weeks waiting for that appointment with my GP. So then in those 3 months, there was even more days where I couldn't move. The hives were more and more consistent. And there'd be days where, like, I'd go swimming, and as soon as I got out of the pool, I was, like, covered in hives.
Really?
So then we're like, okay, maybe it was, like, a chlorine allergy.
Right.
So then we tried swimming in mom's pool. Mom's pool is only salt water.
Right.
There's no chlorine in it. But it's a lot colder. And that was even worse. Like, I could feel the hive starting when I was in the water. And as soon as I got out, it was even worse.
Dang.
So then I was like, okay, it's not chlorine. Like, so at least we could rule out chlorine as a trigger. And then there was one day we were swimming at our house. And I already had, like, a rough day. I had a few hives. And normally when I had hives, I had a lot of the pain also. So I was like, okay. I was like, maybe if I go get in the pool, then since there won't be weight on my legs, then it'll take some of the pain away for a little bit. So I was like, okay, so we'll go swimming. And wife and I went swimming with some friends. And still, even, like, the 2 hours we were in the pool, I couldn't move my left leg because it was still in so much, like, it wasn't in pain because I was in the pool, but it was still so weak that I couldn't bend it. It was just completely straight. So I was, like, swimming with my right leg, and that was it. So then I was like, I need to get out and go, like, try soaking in some more water or something. And as soon as I got out of the pool, all the pressure hit my legs, and I almost collapsed. I could not walk myself because there was so much pain that I just hit my legs since all the pressure was back. That my wife had to walk me back home because I could not move. It was just all the pressure hit my body, and I could not move anything. So then that's when we're like, okay, this is getting really, really, really bad. So then we finally met with a rheumatologist 3 weeks ago. And she did a bunch of tests. They tested me for lupus, came back negative, tested me for rheumatoid arthritis, because all that can be done by blood test. That was negative. My sed rate was a little elevated. So tested me for everything, and then he did the trigger points test, which I don't know if it still does, but it used to help determine fibromyalgia a lot. Like, there's specific parts on your body that if they would press, it'd send, like, shooting pain through you or just be really painful to a fibro patient. Mm-hmm. And he did that, and when I know it's getting kind of dark in here.
Yeah,
it is. So when I was, like, trying to do that to myself at home, just to see if I could feel, like, pain in those areas, and I never really feel anything. Well, then he did it, and it was so much pain, I was, like, jumping out of my seat.
Oh, no.
Because it was so much pain. So then he was like, okay, he was like, yeah, I'm 99% sure that it's fibromyalgia, but he was like, I want you to meet with an allergist to make sure it's not cold or urticaria, which is an allergy to the cold. So, met with an allergist, completely ruled that out, and, wasn't that. So, now I'm having issues with my rheumatologist, because I reached out to them, and I was like, hey, allergist, confirmed, it's no allergy, can we officially get this for fibro, like, officially diagnosis and get a treatment plan started? And he told me that there is no treatment for fibromyalgia, and the only thing you can do is exercise, eat properly, and take Tylenol 3 times a day.
Wow.
So now I'm getting a second opinion because there is treatments for fibromyalgia. He just isn't talking about any of them.
So what are some of the treatments?
So there's some medications for it, like Lyrica, Cymbalta, and a few other ones that just have really strong side effects. And then there's a lot of natural supplements and vitamins and stuff that you can take. So there we go. Yeah. So there's those. Yeah, that's just kind of what happened. So... do you remember when I first started getting the symptoms? Like, when the pain and stuff first started? What was your thoughts then?
I remember, because I asked you, I was like, are you dying?
Are you dying?
And it was like, you're like, it's down to 3 things, you know, we don't know, something like that. I was like, well, are you going to die? And you're like, all of them aren't good for you, but I don't know.
Yeah, because,
like,
it was down to rheumatoid arthritis, fibromyalgia, and lupus.
And MS, right?
No, MS was never a concern.
Oh, okay. But yeah, so I thought you were gonna, like, die.
You were worried.
I didn't know what was going on. I've never seen that.
I was kind of worried, too, until they did all the blood test, and, because I was worried about cancer because of the things I was experiencing.
Okay.
And then they did the blood test, and my white blood count wasn't elevated or anything, so then that's when I was like, okay, at least it's something that's not going to possibly kill me.
Right.
How do you feel now that I have a diagnosis?
It's a hard question, because...
No, it hasn't been very helpful.
And it's not curable.
No.
So, not too great. allergies would have been probably easiest, because you can take a pill for that.
Yeah.
But now you're stuck with something you can't get rid of.
Yeah, I'm just in constant pain all day long.
Yeah.
Like, today's been a really bad day. I'm surprised we're filming as much as we have today.
Yeah, I don't know how I feel. I feel bad.
Yeah. Do you have, like, any concerns?
Yeah.
Like what?
You're in pain all day?
Yeah, like, I'm laughing and it's really not funny, guys, but...
Because you're in pain all day.
Yeah.
I mean, you're going to live the rest of your life in pain. It's crazy. Mm-hmm. But maybe try some of the other treatments that you said you found.
That's what I think. I'm going to try a bunch of the more natural supplements. And I do have a low vitamin D, so I have to take vitamin D supplements.
Okay.
So my allergist did find out I have chronic urticaria, which is just chronic hives with no cause. So that's what the hives are. That's not with the fibromyalgia. So I do have medication for that. So now I'm thinking, a lot of people have told me to try magnesium.
I have heard good things about that.
So, like vitamin D or vitamin B and a few other vitamins. Turmeric is supposed to help a lot. And then there's something else. I don't remember what. But because magnesium is supposed to help with the restless legs, because I have really bad restless legs. But then the one thing I can't figure out how, that's been my biggest struggle besides the pain, because the pain is just a pain, is the fatigue that comes with it. Last week, I was so fatigued. I was falling asleep constantly. By Thursday, I was so tired that on the way home from work, I was spacing out so bad that my wife had to keep being like, hey, like, are you okay? Because she thought something was wrong because I was so spaced out. And I was like, no, just like, I'm that tired. But like, I sleep, most of the time, I sleep all the way through the night. It's just because your body is experiencing so many symptoms and so much pain that it's just completely tearing down your system. And when I do get sleep, half the time my legs are so restless that I'm spazzing and twitching all the time, or I'm rolling over constantly. Do you have anything that you could say to people or family who has someone that is experiencing what I experience?
I mean, hope for the best. You know, care for them through the whole process and everything. What advice do you have for other families out there? Because that's a better question for you, because I don't have...
I know, I think...
I mean, my advice obviously is, care for your family. Yeah.
I think my advice is to realize it's not in their head, because there's a lot of doctors that struggle to believe fibromyalgia is real because you can't do a blood test for it. It's like one of those things that they have to rule out everything else, and then once everything else is ruled out, they're like, okay, it's fibro. And that's just because fibro is defined as like a confused nervous system. So it's your nervous system is oversending pain signals. So like just grabbing my hand like this will send like insane pain through my whole forearm.
What?
Yeah, because your nervous system messes up the way pain signals are supposed to be sent. So it's sending pain signals just for like a simple touch when it shouldn't be. So there's no way to test for that. And there's no full medication that can affect like the nervous system and refunction it. So because there's no test to actually like prove that it's fibro, a lot of doctors don't believe in it and say that it's just in their head.
What?
And just make sure that you realize it's not in their head. Like if they say they're in the pain that they are and they're experiencing the things that they are, that they really are, like I can guarantee you they're in as much pain, if not more, because there's days where I'm in excruciating pain and I just don't say anything. So it's just,
that's
even
crazy.
If they don't look like they're in pain. No, it's a real thing. It's not in their head. And
make
sure
doctors thought that.
Yeah, it's like 50-50 on doctors. Make sure that if they do see a rheumatologist and they're being told just to deal with it, pretty much like I am, take Tylenol, deal with it, that they get a second opinion, because there is options out there. That's more than just Tylenol, because Tylenol is not going to do anything. So just make sure they get that second opinion. They're going to have to be, the person who's experiencing it is going to have to be their own advocate. And if they emotionally or physically or whatever can't be an advocate for themselves at that time or that day, then they need you to be it for them in that appointment. And yeah, just be strong for them. It's a long road. There's a lot of controversy with it and treatment's still not really known. So
that's crazy. 2019 and treatment's not known. Well, comment down below if you know anyone that has a fibromyalgia. And see how they kind of cope with it and stuff like that. We'd love to hear your stories and everything like that. Thanks for watching. Like, subscribe, and comment.
Thank you.